Section 1, we will cover order of operations, absolute value, and exponent rules. First of all, order of operations. Think about the problem. 8 divided by 4 times 2. So try to think of what the answer to that could be. And notice there could be two possible answers, theoretically. If you do the multiplication first, you get 8 divided by 8, which is 1. But if you do the division first, you get 8 divided by 4, that's 2, times 2, you get 4 for an answer. Well, clearly we can't have two answers, so order of operations is a way for us to decide which way we're going to do all these problems, so we'll all do them the same way. Okay, and you've probably heard about PEM, the acronym PEMDAS, sometimes, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, a little reminder to help you remember the order of operations. I'm going to expand that just a little bit. Let's look at first the P from PEMDAS. That stands for parentheses, but I'd like to expand that to include all grouping symbols. So this grouping symbols is number 1 because it could be parentheses. It might be square brackets. Absolute values act like grouping symbols. Fraction bars act like grouping symbols, etc. And if you have nested grouping symbols, remember you work from the inside out. So if you have 1 minus and then parentheses 2 minus 3, let's say you have parentheses in parentheses, you do the 2 minus 3 first. Okay, and then the E in PEMDAS, that reminds you to do exponents. And again, I'm going to expand that to also include roots. If you have square roots or cube roots, those come after grouping symbols. And then next in order would be multiplication and division. And although PEMDAS, you always have the M before the D, that's not necessarily true. Multiplication and division tie in order of importance. So if you have both, you should work left to right. So looking at our example problem from the beginning, we have 8 divided by 4 times 2. And since we have both division and multiplication, and they tie, we work left to right. So the correct answer to this was do the division first, and so we get an answer of 4. Okay, last in our order of operations is addition and subtraction. They also tie in order of importance, so if you have both, you work left to right. Okay, so let's do this example problem. In this example problem down below, we have, what are our operations we have? We have an exponent, we have addition, we have subtraction within an absolute value. So what comes first? Well, remember, grouping symbols come very first, and order of operations says that this absolute value acts like a grouping symbol. So we'll do what's inside of it first. So minus 3 squared plus. So 4 minus 6 is a negative 2. So I'll do what's inside of that grouping symbol. The next thing I'm going to do is actually take the absolute value of negative 2. So the absolute value of negative 2 is 2. So we get to this point. And now what's left? Exponents in addition. Exponents becomes next. We've done all the grouping symbols. So exponents come next. So we have negative 3 squared, so that means negative 3 times 3, because remember what 3 squared means. So this is negative 3 times 3, you can think of it like that. So we get negative 9 plus 2. Lastly, we have addition is the only thing left, so we add negative 7 and negative 9, positive 2, we get negative 7 for an answer. Okay, moving on, here's a little more complicated one. I want you to pause this video and see if you can do this problem on your own, and then restart the video and check your work. Okay, you should have gotten negative 9/10 for your answer. You end up getting a positive 9 in the numerator and a negative 10 down below, so we call that negative 9/10. Check over my work if you didn't get that. Pause the video and check over my work and see if you can find your mistakes. We're moving on. Next topic, absolute value. Now you've probably heard absolute value as defined a couple ways. You've probably heard it defined as the distance from 0 on a number line. So if you look at a number line, here's 0, here's the number 7. They are 7 units apart from each other. There's a distance of 7. So we say that the absolute value of the number 7 is 7. And if you look at a negative value, here's negative 3. 1, 2, 3. And we would say that the absolute value of negative 3 is, well, what's its distance from 0? It's 3 units from 0 on a number line, so its absolute value is 3. So you can think of an absolute value as distance from 0 on a number line. You can also think of it as, just make it positive. That works too. And here's another way to think of it. It's like a two-part definition here. What we're saying, the absolute value of a number is something if that number is positive and something else if that number is negative. Now let's look at this. The absolute value of something is just that something if that something was already positive. In other words, what was the absolute value of 7? It was just 7. Taking an absolute value of a number that's already positive doesn't change the number. But what if you take the absolute value of a negative number? How do we make it positive? One way to make a number that is negative positive is to add another negative. So think of this as the opposite of A. So the absolute value of a number is the opposite of that number if that number is less than 0, so if that number was negative. So this is basically saying the same thing as that. Okay, a couple properties of absolute values. First of all, absolute values are always positive or 0. They're greater than or equal to 0. They can never be negative, although the number inside might be negative. Secondly, the absolute value of a number is equal to the absolute value of the opposite of that number. So the absolute value of 7 equals the absolute value of negative 7. Lastly, the absolute value of a number times the absolute value of another number is the absolute value of those two numbers multiplied. In other words, you can multiply absolute values together. You cannot add them, but you can multiply them. A couple examples here. So I have the absolute value of negative 10 plus 12. So I want to do what's inside first, get the absolute value of 2, and then take the absolute value of 2, and that is just 2. For this one, we have two separate absolute values. The absolute value of negative 10 is 10. The absolute value of positive 12 is 12. So we get 22 for an answer. Lastly, I'm going to do what's inside the absolute values first. So negative 3 plus 12 is 9. Now I'm going to take the absolute values. So negative 2 times 9. Negative 18 is the final answer to that one. Okay, now you're going to be going through a bunch of definitions, and some of them are included in videos within your homework, so I'm not going to go over those, but this one is not. The definition of an exponent, if the exponent is a natural number. So that means if the exponent is a number like 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Not fractions, not negative. That is defined to be n a's all multiplied together. So in other words, if you have 2 to the third, that's 3 2's. So 2 times 2 times 2, so that's 8. So I'm going to write this up here. A to the nth is defined to be a times dot, dot, dot times a, n factors of a. So a couple examples here. Negative 3 to the fourth power, that means 4 negative 3's. So negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3. So we do all this multiplication left to right. We get negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9. Times negative 3 is negative 27, times negative 3 is positive 81. Now the second problem, at first you might think it's the same thing, but it's not, because it's not asking us for 4 negative 3's, it's asking for the negative of 4 3's multiplied together. So the answer to this one is negative 81. Now for the next few slides, you can look at the videos that are within your homework, do the examples down below, and you should be all set for the homework.